Hi everyone, welcome to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. The focus is always on reviewing wearables, not the apps they're connected to. And really, the app quality, its user interface is absolutely key to your enjoyable experience with a tracker, smartwatch or sportwatch. Today we'll be looking into the Zepp app, formerly known as the Amazfit app. We'll walk over the screens, the widgets, as well as all the nooks and crannies where so many goodies are lying around, but so many of Amazfit users simply don't know about these hidden gems. We'll download custom faces, set custom vibrations, schedule events, set goals, and so much more. If you're keen on exploring your Amazfit wearable to its fullest capacity and potential, I advise you to keep this video close as a tutorial or a detailed instructions video. If you only have a specific question, use the timestamps in the description to skip through to the part you need. Another point I want to mention is that the Zepp app is just as proficient on both iOS and Android devices, but this tutorial has been done on Samsung S10, which is an Android smartphone. Also, in order to make this as interactive as possible, you will be able to see the screen recording from my phone on the right side of your screen and the actual recording of me tapping and swiping the icons on the left. Right, let's get into it. First thing is to open the app. You land on the homepage of the app. As you can see on the bottom of the page, there are three main screens: this one, Enjoy, and Profile. On homepage, you have a number of widgets which provide you with the core metrics fed from your wearable every time it syncs with the app. Up top is the steps widget. Inside, you get to see the steps you did over a day, week, month, and year. Below the plot, you get a breakdown of steps taken in the current and prior week. Further down is current versus prior month. Let's get back to home. Now tap on calories on the left below steps. Once again, choose a daily, weekly, or monthly view. Let's put it this way. The newer the tracker or smartwatch you are using, the more data you will have here. I have the GTS1 paired here, and you see what the watch is doing. It's auto-detecting my activities and calculating calories burnt. The GTS picks up slow and fast walking, running, and light activity. The sport profiles you set specifically also get included in the list, something like outdoor running. Back to home and click on sleep. Choose your time period window. You get night plots. I have just two here. You can use your finger to hover over each for details, but it's especially useful to see trends and the averages. You'll see three sleep stages: deep, light, REM, and even short naps. Below the plot is your sleep score, and more importantly, scoring per variable, such as sleep duration, proportion of deep sleep, proportion of REM sleep, etc. When you tap into the details, I like the fact you get a detailed explanation of what the variable you're looking at is and why it's important. Furthermore, there are suggestions on how to improve that variable and even references to medical studies validating those recommendations. Let's jump to home and to the heart rate widget. Self-explanatory here, scroll the chart left or right to view your continuous heart rate. I have occasional data here because I wear the GTS only in prep for reviews. Next screen is Pi. If you haven't watched prior Amazfit or Xiaomi wearables reviews on WesKnows and don't know what the metric does and how it works, the app will show and tell you what you need to know. We know that this single value is your cardiovascular gauge, including your unique health parameters, your activity intensity, heart rate, steps, sleep, and so forth. Essentially, you need to keep the value over 100. And if you don't really know how to do that, the Zepp app will give you 5 different options as examples of what you could do to achieve that 100 points quicker. Check out the tumbler at the bottom of the home screen. It's basically a shortcut to a particular widget that you need to see quickly. Say we want to get to the exercise records. Scroll all the way to the left and tap on the icon. Tap on the activity of interest and you get the full breakdown of that particular exercise with all the plots, stats, metrics, maps, etc. From home, you get an option of either using this icon scroller or the 4 dots icon in the top right of the home page. Essentially, it's the same as the scroller, but now you get the icons written from the top all the way down. I find the scroller at the bottom of home quicker to use as I know the interface quite well. If you're new to the app, it's easier to use this screen for the full breakdown on sleep, calories, pie, and so forth. Okay, so that's the homepage covered. Let's go to the second screen now, namely Enjoy. In my view, this is the function screen, as you set your alarms here, event reminders, set faces, set goals and targets, setting notifications that you want the watch to alert you for, etc. Did you know that you can customize the vibration pattern for all the different types of alerts you have? For example, you can have one for texts, another for an incoming call, and yet another to wake you up. Here's how you do it. Now let's jump to the profile screen. I like to think of it as a summary screen. You can set your goals, look at your records or personal bests. You can add accounts, and my fave here are the Google Fit and Strava. Basically, you share your metrics with some really cool third-party apps. Another awesome feature of the profile screen is the feedback widget. Like, where else have you seen this? Basically, this is your direct line to Amazfit support. Choose your feedback type. You can even upload a screenshot, provide your email, and the Amazfit support will get in touch with you shortly. By tapping on the watch when it's connected to the phone, you get very specific options. Some we have seen from the other screens. Let's tap on the watch face settings and apply a custom face from your phone's gallery. There are more very cool and important functions, such as activity heart rate sharing. You can also adjust the sensitivity of lifting your wrist for the watch to light up. You can put it as normal or into sensitive mode. Heart rate detection is something most of us are concerned about. Some want to switch it off, while some want the max heart rate detection frequency. There's also an option for activity detection. So when the watch detects that you are exercising, it will switch to once per second heart rate measurement. There's also heart rate alert. This is particularly useful for the elderly or those people with underlying cardiovascular conditions. So there you have it. If you do have more specific queries though on the app or where to find things, comment on the vid, ask me the questions on the comments, and I'll try to help you out. Thanks for watching, everyone. If you did find the review and tutorial useful, please click the red subscribe button below the video to ensure you don't miss any of the upcoming content.